Good morning. Our presider for today's Mass is Father Bennett Tran. Please remain standing and join us in singing our opening hymn, number 454. I know that my Redeemer lives, number 454.
And I invite you to direct your attention to the baptismal font. We pray in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Dear friends, let us praise the Lord our God for the water he has created, which will be sprinkled upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Praise you, Almighty God and Father, for you have created water to cleanse and to give life. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ, the Father's only Son, for you offer yourself on the cross, and in the blood and water flowing from your side and through your death and resurrection, the church might be born. Praise you, God the Holy Spirit, for you anointed Christ at his baptism in the waters of the Jordan, so that we might all be baptized into you. We pray by the mystery of this consecrated water, may it remind us of our new and spiritual birth in baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, cleanse us of our sins, and through the Eucharist we celebrate, make us worthy to sit at his table in his heavenly kingdom, where he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son.
May your people exult forever, O God. and renew youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the captain and the court officers had brought the apostles in and made them stand before the Sanhedrin, the high priest questioned them. "We gave you strict orders, did we not, to stop teaching in that name? Yet you have filled Jerusalem with your teaching and want to bring this man's blood upon us." But Peter and the apostles said in reply, "We must obey God rather than men. The God of our ancestors raised Jesus, though you had him killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him at his right hand as leader and savior to grant Israel repentance and forgiveness of sins. We are witnesses of these things, as is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey him." The Sanhedrin ordered the apostles to stop speaking in the name of Jesus and dismiss them. So they left the presence of the Sanhedrin, rejoicing that they had been found worthy to suffer dishonor for the sake of the name. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John,
looked and heard the voices of many angels who surrounded the throne and the living creatures and the elders. They were countless in number, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches, wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, everything in the universe, cry out, "To the one who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor, glory and might forever and ever." The four living creatures answered, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus revealed himself again to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. He revealed himself in this way. Together with Simon Peter, Thomas called Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, Zebedee's sons, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We will also come with you." So they went out and got into the boat. But that night they caught nothing. When it was already dawn, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, have you caught anything to eat?" They answered him, "No." So he said to them, "Cast the net over the side of the boat, and you will find something." So they cast it and were not able to pull it in because of the number of fish. So the disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he tucked in his garment, for he was lightly clad, and jumped into the sea. The other disciples came in the boat, for they were not far from shore, only about 100 yards, dragging the net with the fish. When they climbed out on shore, they saw a charcoal fire with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." So Simon Peter went over and dragged the net ashore, full of 153 large fish. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come, have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they realized it was the Lord. Jesus came over and took the bread and gave it to them, and in like manner the fish. This was now the third time Jesus was revealed to his disciples after being raised from the dead. When they were finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." He then said to Simon Peter a second time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Simon Peter answered him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said to him, tend my sheep. Jesus said to him a third time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was distressed that Jesus had said to him a third time, do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. Amen, amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hand, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he had said this, he said to them, follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite all the first communion candidates to please come forward. Come forward and go ahead and have a seat on the top step there and then on the first step. Yes. Because I want to have a good look at you. And please go ahead and have a seat. And a word of welcome to all who have joined us today. So glad to have you here. And so I'm glad you brought your friends and family with you on this special occasion. So look at you guys. You guys look good. You clean up very well. You know, you almost look as good as I do. And so we rejoice with you on this special day, this important step in the life of faith that you are taking. And the gospel we just heard this morning is one of my favorite because it involves a lot of food, right? Breakfast, barbecuing on the beach, fish and bread. I'm always constantly thinking about where my next meal is coming from, right? But I want to particularly focus this morning on bread. Now, I love bread. Do you like bread too? What kind of bread? What's your favorite kind of bread?
The host.
The host? Oh, that's a pretty good, that's a pretty good answer. Watch out for this one. I think he's after my job. What's your favorite kind of bread? French toast. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Do you have a favorite kind of bread? No? Toast. Okay. Yes. All different kinds of bread. And do you have a favorite one? No? No. You know what my favorite kind of bread is? Nope. Close though. A custard filled Long John. That's surprising, isn't it? Yeah, it's surprising because a lot of time you kind of narrow down what bread is, right? Well, this morning I like us to think more widely, bigger on what bread is. In the gospel today, we hear that Jesus revealed himself. What does it mean to reveal oneself? To show himself, right? To show himself. So he showed himself to his disciples on the beaches there on Lake Tiberias or the Lake of Galilee, right? Those are the same thing. Now, did they recognize him at first? This is a flip a coin question. No, they didn't recognize him at first. It took him a little bit. It took them for them to start catching the fish before they recognized and before they knew that it was Jesus. So it is for us, right? That Jesus reveals himself or show himself to us in bread and wine. And for some of us, it might take us a while to recognize or to know that it is Jesus. But we know that it is Jesus, not because I have told you that it is Jesus, right? Don't believe that because I'm a liar from time to time. Yes. We know that it is Jesus because Jesus tells us that it is him, right? Because on that room, in the upper room is what it's called, on that last night when he was still living and alive on earth. He gathered his closest friends, and he had a meal with them. And as he was eating with them, he took bread. He said the blessing. He broke the bread, and he gave it to them and told them, "Take this bread and eat. This is my body." And the same way he did with the glass of wine, he took it, he said the blessing, and he gave it to them and say, "Take and drink, this is my blood." And so that's why we can be sure that it is Jesus who comes to us in what is seen as bread and wine. But it's a special type of bread, right? It's the bread that Jesus has now made different, that it is he who comes to us. And so we gathered here today with you, excited for you as you take this important step. See, it's the same Jesus that we heard about in the gospel, right, that appeared to Simon Peter and Thomas and Nathaniel and the sons of Zebedee and all those people, that appears now to us, right, that comes to be our friend and to accompany us. And so how wonderful it is, that Jesus continues to come to us. And here's the beautiful thing about it, is that we heard that that was the third time that Jesus came to them after he died and rose from the dead. Well, Jesus comes to us over and over and over again. Every time we gather here for Mass and we say the prayers, we say the blessing, we offer the bread and we break it, and then we give it to each and every one of you. So throughout this weekend, remember sometime during this weekend, thank your mom and dad for bringing you here, right, to take this important step in your life of faith. And here would be my wish, and here would be my prayer for each and every one of you, that, you know, we commemorate and we celebrate this important occasion. But I hope that this is not the only occasion in which you might come to meet Jesus in bread and wine, right? That we do this every day at 8 o'clock, right? Monday through Saturday. So if your time permits, come. Come and meet Jesus every day. And I hope that next week will be the second or third time that you will meet Jesus, and the week after that, and the week after that, and the week after that. See, that's one of the great joys of my life, that each and every day I come to meet Jesus. I come to meet him, whether at this altar here or that altar in the chapel there, or we also have an altar in the rectory, right? That I can literally go downstairs and meet Jesus in the chapel. And Jesus wants to meet with me. I know, can you believe that? Right? And in the same way, he wants to meet with you. And he wants to be in your presence. And so, my friends, my hope for all of you is that as you receive Jesus over and over again, you will grow, first of all, one, more in love with Jesus Christ, two, to recognize him as your friend and your Savior, one that wants to be in deep relationship with you, and thirdly, as you receive Jesus over and over again, you become more and more like Jesus. And so we celebrate and we rejoice with you today. And so a couple things. Why don't we walk through how it is that we should receive Jesus, right? How should we hold our hand? Can you demonstrate for me? Perfect, right? One hand over the other. Can you show that for me? Okay. Yeah, because that will help me out. That way I don't have to guess which hand to give Jesus to you in, right? So if you put one on top of the other, and, you know, because you and I, we tend to be shorter people, if you hold it, like, you know, almost like at your face level and out like this, right, that will help me out, right, rather than holding it down here. Especially for those who are taller, they'll have trouble reaching you, right? So if you hold it out like this, okay? Now, for those of you who would like to receive Jesus in your tongue, you have my permission to open your mouth really wide and stick that tongue out, right? Especially if you see Father Shireman or Father Quayle. Yeah, you just stick that tongue out right at them. Right? They will really enjoy that. Right? So we rejoice with you this morning, okay? And so you can go ahead and go back to your seats. I invite you to please stand with me. Dear friends, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so we may walk with him in newness of life. Let us renew the promises of holy baptism, in which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. Let us now renew our baptismal promises. So I ask you, do you renounce sin as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, was buried, rose again from the dead, is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? My friends, this is our faith. This is the faith of the Church, and we are proud to profess it through Christ our Lord. Amen. God is greater than our hearts and knows everything. Counting upon the Father's boundless mercy, let us now give voice to our needs.
For the bishops, the shepherds of the Church, that they will be filled with the zeal and fervor of divine love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and to the consecrated life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the gospel of life may shed its light on the most vulnerable of human beings, so that their dignity will be recognized and their lives protected, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all children about to receive First Holy Communion, that the gift of the Holy Eucharist will draw them into an unending friendship with the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our military serving in harm's way, that they may be kept safe and serve as an example of compassion and goodwill through the performance of their duties, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that they may resemble the Holy Family as they try to live together in peace and unity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died in the faith of Christ, especially Carol Manis and John Glock, may they experience God's greatest mercy and share in the peace of his kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, your Son taught us to ask for what we need. Filled with confidence, may Jesus' word always remain in us through Christ our Lord.
Seas.
neither money nor weapons for fighting, but nets for fishing, my daily labor. Oh Lord, in my eyes you were gazing, kindly smiling, my name you were saying. All I treasured, I have left on the sand there. Close to you, I will find another seat. Lord, have you need of my labor? Hands for service, a heart made for loving, my arms for lifting the poor.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising, the life of all, has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. Even the heavenly hosts with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he. In the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, he held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Bernard our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace, my God.
Door.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Sing a merry meek and lowly, Virgin Mother, pure and mild. Sing of God's own Son, most holy, who became her little child. Fairest child of fairest mother, God the Lord who came to earth, Word made flesh, our very brother, takes our nature by his birth. Sing of Jesus, Son of Mary, in the home at Nazareth. Toil and labor cannot weary, love enduring unto death. Constant was the love he gave her, though he went forth from her side, forth to preach and heal and suffer, till on Calvary he died. Sing of Joseph, strong and gentle, nobly born of David's house, just and upright man of labor, whom God chose as Mary's spouse. Chosen too as Jesus' guardian, guiding him since infancy. Holy child of holy parents, holy is their family. Glory be to God the Father, glory be to God the Son, glory be to God the Spirit, glory to the three in one. From the heart of Blessed Mary, from all saints the song ascends, and the church the strain re-echoes unto earth's remotest end.
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckon, and I will live forever, you shall live. resurrection. I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise
Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by these eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The chair of your prayer is requested for Patrick Judge, whose funeral we'll celebrate on Friday at 11 a.m. Come grow in your Catholic faith and connect with the church's teaching at the heart of the church. Please consider enrolling in the transformational program at the Catechetical Institute. Come and talk to graduates and current students about the class and upcoming open house in the gathering space after Mass. There will be a new parishioner registration immediately after this morning's Mass in the Refuge. And so if you are new to the area or if you're new to us and would like to register, please stop by the Refuge after Mass this morning. Also after Mass this morning at 9:40, come and learn more about our columbarium. the beautiful new Four Wings Columbarium that we added to Calvary Cemetery, and that will take place at 9:40 in FCC Room 8. If you can't make it today, we're hosting another session on Thursday, May 9th at 8:40 in the morning, and also on Monday, May 13th at 6:30 at night. A $100 gift card will be given away during each presentation. And so, you know, attend and put your name in for an opportunity to win that. And once again, please join me in congratulating our young friends who have just received their first communion. My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth to seek love and serve our Lord Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your heart. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. I will give thanks to you, my Lord. You have answered my plea. You have saved my soul from death. You are my strength and my song. Sing to the mountains, sing to the sea. Raise your voices, lift your heart. This is the day the Lord has made. Let all the earth rejoice. Holy, holy, holy Lord. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Sing to the mountains. Made, let all the earth rejoice.